So this is the second example. I want to wrap up now what I did. I got the bar. One time I fix this side and I move this side. It is boundary value broke by one. And another time I got the bar fixed from here, but with domain loading, which is very, very annoying. And I compute the reaction using the differential equation approach. Whether this one or this one, I can compute the displacement at any point I want. For example, if I want to compute the displacement at this point or this point, it's very simple. I will return to the slide here. Here, I will return to this slide. Just allow me 1 second. I will return to this slide. Here is the the expression for you. Just substitute with x by L over 2. The same here. Here we have the displacement expression here. Here, substitute here by x equal to L over 2. And we have a certain way to check these numbers. We can use virtual work, any type, any easy technique from structural mechanics to check these values. We will have these values. The question now is, what if I want the bar under fix it like this, and we have here concentrated load P. This is the third example. Okay? For example, this load from here by value A, and this is L minus A. How can I solve this problem using this differential equation approach? The easiest way to do that is straightforward. It's not a big problem to do that. How? Is to divide this into two zones. We have two zones here. So we have direct solution. We will divide this into two zones. This is zone one, this is zone two. Okay? We have two zones. And on the interface between these two zones, here in this zone one, I will start from this point, I will have x1. And from here, I will have, start from this point, x2. And I have compatibility equation conditions at the intersection point, which means x1 equal A and x2 equal 0 at this intersection point. We knew that the displacement at zone 1 at x1 equal A equal to the displacement at zone 2 at x2 equal 0. And we have another equilibrium condition, the force at the first zone at x1 equal A plus the force at zone 2 at x2 equal 0 equal to the force P. And all of these forces in these directions. Okay? So, based on the given boundary conditions and with this compatibility condition and equilibrium condition, I will be able to solve this problem. It's not a problem. Here we have no domain loading. We can solve this problem. But I will leave it to you, for the students, to try this. I have the solution with me. I can send it. It's not a problem. But you can do it, and you can get it direct. But in boundary elements, we will not do that. Okay? We'll use alternative technique. Hence, we need to introduce, before going for the alternative technique, we introduce the idea of the Dirac delta. We have to introduce one of the greatest idea in the history, actually, of the Dirac delta. The Dirac delta may be returned to Professor Paul Dirac, who is a very famous name in quantum mechanics, actually. And the idea of the Dirac delta in quantum mechanics is different from the idea of Dirac delta in boundary elements. Actually, the idea of Dirac delta in quantum mechanics is observation. How to simulate the observation in quantum mechanics. But actually, here, we will use it to represent discontinuity. And actually, the Dirac delta is not a function. Some papers write Dirac delta is a function, but it is generalized function. That is not a function. Okay? To introduce the idea of the Dirac delta, I will come back to very easy function, which is f of x equal to the absolute x. If we draw this function on the x-axis and f of x here, we will have this kind of 45 degree here and 45 degree here, and we always come to this point, put black point here. Because the function here is continuous and differentiable. Continuous and differentiable because you have the limit from this direction equal to the limit from this direction. This is basic mathematics. So if I want to write this function in alternative way, I will write this function in this. It is equal to x as far as x greater than or equal to 0, and it is equal to minus x as far as, x less than or equal to 0. I can write it in this direction. Okay? I want to differentiate with this function because this function is differentiable at any point, is continuous and differentiable. So f dash of x equal to, I will look at this technique. So it is equal to 1, and here it is equal to 1. And now if I want to plot it, it will be like this. And now I have to put a white circle here. I have to put a white circle here. Because here is plus 1, and here is minus 1. So here x greater than 0, here x less than 0. And now the function is not defined at 0, because it has two values. The function is not defined and is not differentiable at 0. Okay? But we will differentiate. Okay? So if we want to differentiate it again, so the function, it has nothing at 0. And it is 0 everywhere. So it is actually is not defined at 0 and it is 0 everywhere. This is what we call it the Dirac delta. At 0. This is the idea, it is isolation of the discontinuity. So the function, it is everywhere is 0, except at 0, it goes to infinity. It goes to infinity at 0. And actually, if you look at it more carefully, in generalized function, maybe there is a guy called Schwartz who developed this, it is like a measure, or it is a Gaussian distribution when we have very tiny, tiny base here goes to 0 and the integral inside it is equal to 1. This is the beauty of the Dirac delta. Okay? This is the beauty of the Dirac delta. So, if this Dirac delta is not at 0, so I can say the Dirac delta is not at 0. So, if it is at x, for example, if it is at a, so I can put x equal to a. Because of that, I'm going to define a certain definitions now. I'm going to define a certain definition now. For example, if I have my bar like this, this is my bar. It is fixed from this direction and is fixed from this direction. And there is a concentrated load here, P, capital, at x equal a, and this is x, here is x equal a, and this is l minus a. We will define p of x now as a function, the domain load equal to the capital B, the value of the concentrated load, times delta of x minus a. This is not a minus, this is a definition. This is not a minus, this is a definition. Okay? I will define some integrals. I will define, all of these are definitions. I will define integrals so that the integral of x minus a, for example, when we go to two dimension, we will not write x minus a, we will write it x comma a. Okay? So this kind of definition. So when we integrate the Dirac delta times dx, for example, here, equal to, some people, they put the dx at the beginning of the integral. Both of them are the same. This is means we return to the step function of the unit step function. We will give it 1/2, I will say from where the 1/2 come, sine of x minus a plus, of course, constant and so on. Okay, this is the sine function. The sine function, it means it is positive or negative. Why you put 1/2? We put 1/2 mainly for the symmetry. For the symmetry, because we want everything to be symmetric. I like the idea of the symmetry even in the universe. Okay, so we want everything to be symmetric. So we want the load before the load and the after the load. We can change this value. We can change this value as far as both the load before the load and after the load equal to the 1. Okay? So this is by definition. Okay? So if we want to integrate again this here, dx, so it will be 1/2 the sine function of x minus a times x minus a. We can multiply by x. Not by a, is not a problem, but we put x minus a to facilitate the algebraic expressions. And we have the right to put x minus a because we have here constant. And all of this part is constant part, is not a problem. We can add it just to simplify problem. Be sure that the value of the sine function, this is the sine function. But here is 1/2 and here is 1/2. This is the step function. Okay, the sine function, actually, some people, they wrote it as h of something. It is the sine function. Okay, and this is a way to simulate partially distributed load. Okay, I will give an idea and I will leave it after that to you to think. Again, if we want to integrate all of this part here again, so it is equal 1/2 sine of x minus a, this is a sign, it is a sign itself, the sign whether it is positive or negative, times x minus a square over 2, and so on. And we can go again in the integration. So the idea of the Dirac delta itself is a simulation of the discontinuity. Because of that, when you in normal calculus, we have elementary functions. If this is elementary functions, after that, we have special functions, more than these are special functions. And by adding only the Dirac delta, we get all of this as the generalized function. So when we add the Dirac delta itself to anything, so we will be able to simulate the discontinuity. Okay? Again, if you come back to this slide here again, the Dirac delta, it is the simulation of the discontinuity. Coming back in a state of derivative by integration, we'll get the sine function. This is the sine function. The sine, whether it is positive or negative. Coming back, we'll get the cone function. They call it cone function or something like that. And so on, we can get a lot of discontinuities after that. Big something to inform, sometimes we need the derivative of the Dirac delta. This is called generalized derivative. We will not use it except in one application, in one dimension only. Here, if we want to simulate the bending moment in beams, we will need the derivative only because the bending moment is dipole. It is dipole, so we will need the definition of the derivative of the derived delta. Okay, but this is later after that.